Hello, everyone, and welcome to the final 2023 episode of IDZ News. This month, we'll be looking at the release of PyTorch 2.1, and we'll glance at the oneAPI 2024.0 release. As always, I'd like to encourage you all to follow the links in the description to learn more about everything we discuss in this video. First up, read the blog PyTorch 2.1 contains new performance features for AI developers. This blog discusses the five features that Intel contributed to PyTorch 2.1. Torch inductor CPU optimizations, including bfloat 16 inference path for torch.compile, CPU dynamic shape inference path for torch.compile, C++ wrapper, flash attention-based scaled.product algorithm for CPU, and PyTorch 2 export post-training quantization with an x86 backend through an inductor. Read the blog to get details about each of these five features and try out PyTorch 2.1 to realize the performance benefits for yourself. Next up, I'm pleased to announce that we've just released our fourth major release of oneAPI and AI developer tools. With this release, we've taken major steps forward to enable open, accelerated computing through standard-based software, giving developers hardware choice and performance. The 2024.0 release gives developers hardware choice, future-ready programming, accelerated application performance, and it unleashes developer productivity. There's too much to go into in this short video, so check out the upcoming oneAPI Dev News episode, which goes into a bit more detail, and follow the links in the description to read the release notes, where you can really dig into this exciting new release. For our last topic this month, I just want to take a moment to say thank you to everyone that has been watching videos on the Intel Software YouTube channel. 2023 was a fantastic year. We've gotten tons of great videos from our colleagues, our friends, and our partners, and I'm really looking forward to an exciting 2024. I hope you'll all continue to join us as we explore topics like AI, oneAPI, HPC, and much more. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel, and I'll see you next year.